OCT can help in management of glaucoma as it gives us information regarding the retinal fiber layer around the disc and the disc itself, together with the ganglion cells within the macular area. OCT is an indispensable tool for the diagnosis and for detection of progression of glaucoma. Multiple studies have shown the ability of OCT to differentiate between glaucomatous and non-glaucomatous eyes and to demonstrate glaucoma progression. The different parameters of OCT are reproducible. We have different machines of OCT, and also we have different generations of OCT. This is the Zeiss time domain Stratus OCT. As you can see here, this is the ring examined around the disc. The nerve fiber layer thickness is detected, and the numbers are displayed here in hours or sectors, and it's compared with the normative data. This is for the right eye, this is for the left eye, and this is the comparison between right and left eye. In time domain, examination is done around a circle of a diameter 3.4 millimeters. 256 e-scans are applied. Starts with the temporal, then going to the superior, nasal, inferior, back to the temporal. And this is what we have, starting from temporal, ending in temporal. And you notice normally we have increased thickness in the superior and the inferior parts of the retinal fiber layer. And this is the comparison between the two eyes. For the optic disc, the time domain used to apply 6 linear scans and the level of retinal pigment epithelium is determined. Then the machine will go up by 140 microns and create a level. Anything above that red line is considered rim area. Anything below it is a cup area. So this is the way it goes with the time domain. Now we have the spectral domain OCT. It's called the Cirrus. As you can see here, this title shows that it's examination of the retinal fiber layer and the optic head with the 200 by 200. This is for the right eye and this is for the left eye. What's meant by 200? That in one line there are 200 scans and this is repeated 200 times, covering an area of 6 by 6 millimeters. Before reading a paper, you must be sure if it is of a good quality. For the Cirrus OCT, we need a signal strength 6 or higher, 6 up to 10. Later, we're going to talk about the Optovue. You need a signal strength 30 or higher. So here, signal strength is good. This area will show the thickness of the retinal fiber layer, and this is the deviation map. If the numbers are similar to the database, it will be in gray, but if it's away, it will be in yellow or red. Yellow means it's found in 5% of the population only, and red means it's found in 1% of the population. The machine determined the end of the Bruch's membrane, then locate the center of the area, then draw a circle of 3.4 millimeter and start to calculate the thickness of the retinal fiber layer along this surface. And this is the result. This is the left eye and the right eye, starting from the temporal back to the temporal, and the numbers are displayed here in hours or in sectors. And the same clue, if it's 1% of the population, it will be red. If it occurs in 5%, it will be yellow. And then this part will show us the average nerve fiber layer thickness for one eye and the other, and the symmetry between both eyes. And these are the disc parameters. For the disc parameters, you have to be sure that the machine determines the end of the Bruch's membrane. Usually the machine make a mark on the Bruch's membrane and on the internal limiting membrane, and the machine calculate the nerve fiber layers present between the Bruch's membrane opening and the minimal distance to the internal limiting membrane. So you need to check this part. This part will show horizontal section and vertical section of the disc, horizontal and vertical. So you need to make sure that the machine correctly identified the Bruch's membrane. So this is perfect, then you accept the results. The last part here, this is the ring, the 3.4 millimeter ring of the retina, and you have to check this part to make sure that the segmentation, the definition, the localization of the retinal fiber layer was correct by the program. Then how we can make use of this? First, we check that the profile of the right and the left eye, they go hand by hand. Symmetry is an essential normal thing. Second, you need to check that there is the normal double hump appearance of the nerve fiber layers. It is more in the superior and inferior parts. Then you can check these. Isn't rule, is it followed or not? If there is inferior thinning, is there is superior thinning? But don't take it for granted that everything is abnormal. For example, in this study done on 125 eyes of glaucoma and 96 eyes of normal people, the isn't rule got a sensitivity of 80% and a specificity of 30%. So 30% of the normals can be included in this part. If you depend on inferior thinning, I'm going to diagnose glaucoma in 60%, but with the sensitivity 84%. If you depend on thinning of the superior part, I'm going to diagnose glaucoma in 30%, but you get a very high sensitivity of 83%. The different parameters of the disc are displayed here. If we go to the Optovue, here you can see it's the nerve head and retinal fiber layer analysis of the left eye and of the right eye. This is the edge of the disc, and this is the cup. Then the machine check an area 4 millimeters centered around the disc. As you can see, this color part, you get a clue here of the thickness of the nerve fiber layer. Then the machine make a ring at 3.4 millimeters, determine the thickness of the retinal nerve fiber layer, and the values are displayed here. And again here, all in green, but if it's abnormal, you can see some of the sectors will be displayed in yellow or in red. The same comparer for right eye, left eye with the normative data, and this is the comparison between right and left eye. One eye is a straight line, the second eye is a hatched line. So you can see here the same printout, and in the middle you can see these numbers, Here, you can see the retinal fiber layer thickness parameters, and these are the disc parameters. This is for the three-dimensional, and this is for the two-dimensional parameters. In this machine, the retinal fiber layer end is determined. Then the machine will go upper with a level of 150 microns above the first line, and everything is above is determined as a neural rim, and everything below is a cup. So you can see each machine has its own parameters for determination of the neural tissue and the cup. That means you cannot compare results of different machines. So in the Cirrus, this is the ring diameter, and in Optovue, this is the ring diameter. The technique is different. In the Cirrus, we get an examination 200 by 200. If you come to the Octave View, you can see here the machine will test 13 circles with diameters starting from 1.3 up to 4.9, then centered with 312 radial lines. The extent of each of these lines is 3.7. Then we get this circle. In the Cirrus, we have 256 scans, while in the Optovue, you have a 775 scans. Again, you cannot compare results of different machines. Then we come to the ganglion cells in the macula. In the Optovue, the machine calculates the whole ganglion cell complex, the ganglion cells, the inner plexiform layer, and their extension to the brain. This is the inner fiber layer. So all these are included. This is known as the ganglion cell complex. In case of Cirrus, the Carl Zeiss, they avoided the inner fiber layer as they concentrate on calculating the ganglion cells and the inner plexiform layer. So it's always, you can see it written as ganglion cell IPL layer. So this is known as the ganglion cell analysis, and this is known as the ganglion cell complex. Again, in the Cirrus, you can do this by 200 with 200, or you can choose 512, this is 512 by 180. 128 lines. This is going to cover 6x6 area, but the ganglion cells detected will be in this area only. It will be in an area with a horizontal diameter 4.8 and a vertical diameter 4 millimeters, missing this oval area with a vertical diameter of 1 milli and horizontal 1.2 milli. Why that? Because the machine cannot detect the ganglion cells outside or inside here. That's why this is the area tested. And this is the shape of the printout. Again, left eye, right eye. This is the thickness, and this is the comparison with the normal. If it's abnormal, then you can have a yellow or red. And this is the number of sectors in each eye. And this is here you can check the segmentation to accept the results. And again, you can see here the signal strength. You can see here it was made by 512 multiplied by 1 to 80 in this particular case. Another example for one eye and for the other eye, with the abnormality shown in red or in yellow. In case of Optovue, the machine will examine an area 7x7 through 15 vertical lines with one horizontal line, and this is the printout. Either you can have a thickness of the retinal fiber of the ganglion cells, or if there is deviation, The area in blue means that there is a loss of 50% of the ganglion cells. If it's in blue, this means there is a loss of 25% of the ganglion cells. This is known in the deviation map. If you go to the significant map, the area in red means that it occurs in 1% of the population, and the area in yellow means that it occurs in 5% of the population. So this is the printout you can see in some of the cases. Right eye, left eye. This is the right side, this is the left side. Here you have the optic nerve and the retinal fiber around with the comparison here. And here you have the ganglion cell area with the either significance or other things like the normal thickness, or you can have it with the deviation. And this is the reverse. This is the left eye, and this is the macular area of the left eye, and this is the comparison between the retinal fiber layer around the disc of right and left eye. One of the important parameters when it comes to the ganglion cell complex is written here. This is the FLV. This is the focal loss variance. Loss variance is something like the standard deviation, and we found that here you can see global loss variance and have focal loss variance. It was found that the focal loss variance is a very high significance to detect abnormalities in glaucoma. In general, the ganglion cell map have a good quality for the diagnosis, reaching a sensitivity up to 99%. But with less than 80% specificity. For further information about the subject, please check the presentation of pitfalls when reading an OCT report.